See you next Tuesday. Old See man Milk Emporium. all right, I gotta run to the bathroom.
Too much ruin them.
Too much ruin. Oh my god! Like those moments when we start telling the story, and it becomes like the in thing to do to drop references to ruin them about how I don't know if it ruined civilization, but it certainly ruined my Monday morning. Who else was vomiting up this delicious honey wine brandy mix?
Yeah. If you you should do like a short documentary with history experts.
When you say you,
I mean the plural you.
That's the one. That's the one. I'll tell you what, whoever makes a Ruin'em documentary, first thing that goes on next week's episode of NSFW. That's
I will volunteer to provide quotes.
Oh, dude, if you want, okay, if you want to do this, whoever you are, put together a little 2 to 3 minute documentary, cut over, and Tom Merritt will provide quotes for it. And tell
the story. I will record video of, you know, whatever it is that needs to be said.
Yes.
From an expert point of view.
Yes.
So I'll do this. I'll put the suit on.
Oh my God. Should I hit up Gary Vaynerchuk and see if we could get him to be like to get him to be one of the experts in this wine.
The thing about the Romans.
This wine documentary.
Yeah, you should. You absolutely should. See if he finds the humor in it, if he's on board. That'd be hilarious.
I think I think we need a fully formed idea before we go to like somebody like Gary V. Like we have to have everything, all of our ducks in a row and like a pitch ready to go. And then like once now our joke ducks. Is complete. Wait, what?
Where are you going to get ducks?
I don't even know what that means, AdBot.
But you don't know what AdBot means. You didn't hear us talking about the AdBot?
I do ad reads, man. I won against the Ad Dragon. I'm allowed to do ad reads.
I don't know, man.
I do the same funny ad. Everyone always said, hey, old laugh a minute gerbs with his ad reads.
Yeah, but you're not very funny anymore. You don't.
I feel like everybody, Brian, I feel like that's your own opinion, man. Like, I feel like everybody's laughing a lot at my ad reads.
No. They're shocked at how all you do is.
And Amy Chan says they're perfect, Justin.
Okay.
But, I mean, would she say that if they weren't?
I guess not. I don't know.
Are you calling her a liar?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not. Because I don't like it when Amy Chan kicks my ass.
All right, what do we call it? You want to call this Deathstarter? Deathstarter. It's got to be Deathstarter.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. This is NSFW episode 170, recorded on double complete rainbow. Here we go. This is NSFW episode 170. Wow, double click.
Oh, sorry. Last minute change. Do you want to change the name of the show too? I thought you meant pulling babies from wombs.
No, I don't.
Okay, just asking.
There we go. This is NSFW episode 170, recorded on March 19th, 2013. Deathstarter. Sucker.
Oh yeah, no, it is a jury. I was suggested that we should call it Jury Home Invasion. That's actually how I came in. It was through the window with a mask on.
Of course you did. Why wouldn't you, sir?
All right. On this edition of the NSFW show, we're joined by Tech News Today's Tom Merritt. We discuss whether or not the Death Star blowing up was an inside job, what to do with our brand new wine scheme, Ruin'em, and a Kickstarter for me and Merritt that'll blow your drawers off. It's all coming up on this edition of the NSFW show. I'm going to kiss you on the mouth.
I'm going to go to the restroom while you do the...
With your drawers
the
off.
The sponsors.
Not my drawers, shouts E. Delahenty.
You blew my drawers off and kissed me on the mouth.
All right. This episode of NSFW is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform that makes it fast and easy to create a professional website, blog, portfolio, and now an online store. Check out their Sorry, everybody. Try that one more time. This episode is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform that makes it fast and easy to create a professional website, blog, portfolio, and now an online store. Check out their new commerce solution so you can start selling your stuff immediately. For a free trial and 10% off your first purchase on new accounts, go to squarespace.com and use offer code NSFW3. And then between ads, you want to just let everybody know that there's another ad read to come. So you have to say...
And by...
And
by
Ting.com. Ting is a new mobile phone service.
And then we keep talking. Sorry, go ahead.
And Ting.com. Ting is a new mobile phone service that makes sense. Save money with Ting. Pay for what you use. Doesn't require a contract and offers unlimited devices on one pooled plan. To save $25 on your first Ting device, visit nsfw.ting.com. That's nsfw.ting.com.
Man, it's so weird.
Scissor kick a little girl. Woo!
Man.
See, Brian, I like to make a lot of jokes here on this show, and they all involve physically assaulting something smaller or weaker.
Yeah, that's just weird.
That's the jokes I make.
It's pretty weird.
Your payment has succeeded.
Weird. It's just weird.
B. Delahenty.
Says what?
It's just like you know, like the running meme in the chat room, yeah, of checking off a thing.
Oh, what? That's the NSFW bingo thing.
Okay.
Do they still have NSFW show bingo? /BINGO.
BINGO.
Oh, wait. The site's down, of course, because it's down. That's a bummer.
Dude, we only have 144 backers for FSL tonight.
That's insane. And yet,
we're done. We're funded. We're good. Unless they're all like punking us and they withdraw their pledges on the last day.
Please don't do that.
Those guys are asses.
I would appreciate that not happening.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to hit stop.
And by the way, they are like all 100 and under. Like,
yeah, yeah. There's like 2 450s.
God damn it.
And 1 150. Everything else is below that.
Hey, Jammer B, I'm real sorry, but it looks like this local recording module just crapped the bed and didn't work.
We're good here.
All right. Well, I mean, I'm bummed that this is a recurring thing in the new Vid Blaster setup.
Send the computer back.
Yeah, we're getting recommendations from the person next to me who owns this house that you should send your computer back.
No way. Ain't going to happen. Because my friends over at Doghouse Systems make incredible computers like this one. You can get the
Brian Brushwood's Max Trollbox.
That's not
when you think of the Max Trollbot character, think of Brian Brushwood.
Not Justin Robert Young, who actually invented Max Trollbot.
Who's selling you the Max Trollbox.
Okay, for the record, they said, we want to make you a computer. What art do you want in it? We could put your BB logo. I was like, don't let me decide that. It's the fans.
Use my beloved creation, Max Trollbot, to sell these.
Hey, Brian, did I show you my Ira Sockman doghouse?
God damn it. You're killing me. Although in all fairness, it was Chad who made the Max Trollbox, the Trollbot.
It was John, wasn't it?
No, it was Chad. Chad built and designed. You don't even know who designed the physical thing.
Oh, no. John was in it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wait. What are you talking about, Justin? Max Trollbot was in it.
Right.
No, I mean like in his heart.
Oh, right. Inspired him. I see. Gotcha.
Yeah.
For a minute, I thought you were saying, it doesn't matter. That's.
Do you guys want to break down a video?
Yeah, man.
All right.
That's okay. How long do we have here?
I want to like really criticize it.
Well, no, the kids come back at what, 9:30?
No, they're already back.
Oh, are they? Okay. Don't
worry. Isn't that like a thing where you break down a friend by just insulting them constantly?
Break some like break high school prank is what you'll do. Hey, can we talk just a little minute about
sure, yeah.
Okay. Next
no.
week?
So ooh, talking.
Next week we need to do the movie draft.
Yes.
Can we talk about who's in and who's out?
Oh crap. We do have to figure that out.
So whoever won the winner draft is out.
No! So three of us and I know Cargill is
By the way, don't think that I don't appreciate that I just got lumped right in like on the first round. That's awesome. I love being part of this draft.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you became part of the DNA when we started doing the winner one on frame rate.
Yeah. Once it became a marriage between NSFW show and frame rate, which I think is a fantastic association for sure. Okay. People who are we already socially obligated to bring in? Who already Cargill, thinks they're in? Cargill,
Scott
Johnson. That means we got one spot left.
Wait, did we promise Kanata? Did we get drunk at the wedding and promise Kanata?
We may have already invited Kanata.
But also, I mean, people are saying, what happens to the token lady? We always have a token
Sarah
lady.
Sarah likes doing it, too.
Oh, jeez.
I mean the draft.
We we can share a spot. Should we? Damn it. Should we go seven people? That'd change the dynamic considerably.
I mean, can we add movies?
I think we have a lot of movies.
Well, there
are movies that aren't in there.
You could lower the money.
No.
You could add one person and then say it's like 75 or 90 or something like that.
Oh, crap. No, that's actually not a bad idea.
No, it's got to be 100.
Yeah.
I guess it really doesn't matter what the amount is.
Yeah, because you adjust to the market, right?
Yeah, right. That's true.
All right. First of all,
Clintrack is saying we did invite Canada. I mean, and I don't know whether or not it was all of Canada, or just a certain province.
Canada's a myth.
Yeah, apparently Canada's not even real.
Not even real.
I don't know why you guys keep bringing up Canada. As if it exists.
I mean, I guess, is Dan Dirks in the chat room?
Oh, dude, there's so many people I would love to bring in on this. Dana Brunetti would be amazing. I found out that recently, like, the guy who does Slash Film, who has like 100,000 followers, is a fan of Scam School and a totally cool guy who I've started following.
I mean, do we do two leagues?
No.
Two divisions?
It's not sustainable, I don't think.
And the point of the main league is not just setting the bar for everybody else to play, but it's also the fun of holding the draft. And if you do two divisions, then that's just a lot of people to get through.
It doubles the tedium. Like, that's the only weak spot is the tedium of going through it. And you're going to double it.
Well, I mean, like,
twice.
We're only doing one on NSFW.
Right.
And that is the league. I mean, because, like, there is that it's gotten big enough. Luckily, this idea has taken root enough that it's popular.
Right.
And, like, I feel like now is the time when we need to start just drawing a line around, like, our personal fun league. Like, Tom was nice enough to invite me into his fantasy baseball league that he's had with his friends forever that I promptly completely ignored last season, and now he is shaming me into participating because I have accepted this honor and I need to take part in it. And that's a me thing. However, like, I feel like now's where we need to start saying, what is our friends league that, like, we enjoy? And then going forward, like, to grow the idea of this league, do we just have another thing where it's like, hey, listen, we do all of, you know, we do the slash film, we do Jeff Cannata, we do, you know, maybe all the other people that we haven't put in our league that we do want to take part in.
Now, here's the one question is what if we went for teams? Like, would that be a thing?
Yeah, I was wondering how that, if that would work.
So like,
I'm not being on a team. That's, how about this for teams? You team up with anybody you want. I'm on team jury, and that's it.
This is how serious the game's gotten. This is how we know we're onto a good thing.
Okay, well, okay. What if it's six captains who can recruit as many or few people on their team as they want?
So are you?
So Justin can
Sarah?
Be a loner and just be like, it's just me, and I don't care. You know, Brian can invite Kanata and a couple again, Cargill, and he can like team the brains. You know, I actually kind of brought Eileen in last summer on the last summer draft.
Actually, that's not a bad idea.
So, all right, y'all can bring 40 people in like a flop house. I don't care. I got a title to defend.
This is how heavy duty, man. This is how serious he takes that,
dude. The captains are the face of the draft, right? So, you know, if Brian has a team, he makes the call. He's the one that is doing the bidding, but he's got his advisors.
Man, I feel like we just need another league, man. Like, we just need another, we need another draft. Like, and maybe that's its own podcast.
Ben Johnson in 1901.
Dude, here's the question. Like, to double the draft, I believe, pushes us into a realm of tedium that
So we don't need to broadcast it. I mean, like, is your issue that we're broadcasting it or that you don't want to do another draft? Because I would love, after I do the draft, that's all I want to do is draft again.
Yeah, I feel like it should be like an offline secret thing and we can publish the results of it.
Oh, really?
I mean,
I know people will be disappointed because that's here, Brian. Here's the problem is that you're saying we need to do it offline, and then how many people would be like, this sucks, publish, live stream the draft?
Yeah, right. Well, I mean, no, at that point, just don't make it an episode. You're saying, oh, it's not as good as an episode, but you can still live stream it.
Okay, but here's the problem for everything is there's no way that it won't leak into NSFW and frame rate. Because what will happen is we'll end up talking about like, well, here's what's going on in the draft. And then somebody's like, yeah, but in the other draft, I'm doing really well. And you should go to the otherdraft.org is the place to go.
Brian, the reason why me and Tom don't think that this is a problem is because being parts of multiple fantasy leagues, and I don't know about Tom, but listening to fantasy baseball and football podcasts, this is something that they have managed to survive. The idea that people play in multiple drafts and talk about multiple leagues and talk about like the fact that they've done different things in different leagues. Like it happens. This is the symptom of a popular idea taking root.
Hmm. Well, you don't have to do separate leagues. That's what I didn't think. I thought you were saying make it a larger league, but because it's not going to be as interesting with a lot of people, you just do it as a separate live stream. That's not a show.
I do believe we should add a seventh slot. And we can have either Sarah or Veronica join us.
Oh, Brian, why'd you even say two names? You should have just said Sarah. God damn it.
Now we have eight.
If we're gonna have eight players, we gotta add some more movies then.
We need more movies.
Oh, Padre SJ, people are saying. Ah, damn it. It's a great game. Justin, can we take just... All right, just allow us this moment. Justin, remember that time like 3 years ago, 4 years ago, when you called me and you're like, I got an idea. We should do like a fantasy baseball thing only for movies.
No, I remember you called me and said, Justin, I have a brilliant idea. I want to have a fantasy movie draft. Also, I've come up with a character named Max Trollbot. And eventually I'm going to sell computers with his face on.
That's not my fault. I gave it to the chapter. I said,
this is what I remember.
God damn it. I love hate you. God damn it. people on Twitter are saying that we should do a frame rate versus NSFW thing and make it like a SmackDown versus Raw thing, where it's like, well, there's separate just me entities. Versus
Justin,
that's
yeah, basically.
Well, I could be the commissioner in the middle.
But like, at the same time, like, why?
What if? Hold on. What if I retired since I've won the winter and summer movie drafts? I retired from the game and instead.
And you like running the draft too. Are you gonna miss it though? Is that gonna be fun for you?
I would miss it effing terribly. You should do that. It would be very difficult for me not to play.
Yeah, what are you? And besides, yes, you won the World Series once and the Puerto Rican leagues. Like, congratulations.
All right, so the smack talk begins. I see.
I mean, just saying, the winter draft is not even a real draft. Like,
oh, it's like the World Baseball Classic. All the movies make
5 cents.
There's only one
real league. That's the summer league.
The toe tag says, but who would buy all the April movies?
I mean, here's the deal. I think going to 8 players is not a bad idea. We just need to add more movies. Dude, we just need to add every movie that's coming out during the summer.
8 is a lot. Because like
Pain and Gain isn't in this draft, which I think is going to be a good play.
Right.
I think there's a lot of stuff that's out there that is coming out in theaters that is not in there. So,
well, and this is a way wild card. God, 8 people is a lot though, man. I would just say 7.
You're the one who started naming a bunch of names that everyone's going to scream and yell about. And now, like, we're, like, putting out the person.
You're right.
You named.
We should go down to 5. You're right. Back to 5.
Wait a minute. Now that I'm thinking about it, I don't know that more people actually makes it any slower because it's an auction. It's not like each person takes a turn. So it's the number of movies that creates the tedium.
We're going to have massive inflation on the price per movie. And
that's great.
Is it?
Well, and one of the things that is less interesting about the draft that I've noticed is there will be several movies where nobody's bidding, where it's just like, you know, 8, 9,
so
done.
That worked out well for me with Lincoln, so I'm okay with this
so
already.
So if you have more people, you have a more chance to have more bidding wars, which is more exciting.
All right. Brian, Jury, Tom, Cargill, Kanata, F-Dog, Sarah, and Veronica.
Also, there is the technical question of whether or not that's even possible to have 8 people on a show to draft.
Oh, on Skype, yeah.
I guess we could do Google Plus, though. We could do a Hangout.
I could have the 3 of us Skype in, and I could add a 4th person.
I wonder if I'm going to be in Petaluma next week.
What about Google Hangout, though?
Hello.
How do you feel about wearing baggy sweaters?
If only we knew somebody at Google.
If only there was a company that like pretty much was making their name producing Google Hangouts, and they shared a building with Twit, and they were full of producers who just do that.
Yeah, dude.
If only.
That's crazy talk, son. What's going on?
Gosh darn it.
Jeez.
I'll be in Vegas next week.
8 people is a lot.
Yeah. Let it all ride on Hanley Ramirez. just so you know, for years I've tried to get like my fantasy baseball league worked into some kind of podcast somewhere.
Yeah.
As if it were a real entity that had like real fans. So this is my latest attempt at that.
Okay.
It's not entirely.
Somebody suggested you could have a 1st and 2nd movie draft league with relegation and promotion at the end of the season.
Oh, that's interesting.
That's actually...
I mean, like, I don't know why we just can't have... I mean, like, we can't just be like every... Like the conventions of fantasy sports are there for us. You just have different leagues.
No, hold on. I kind of like this idea. So it's like we've got the Premier League and we've got the... I don't know.
So we're inviting people into the Kmart League, or we're telling people that have already been in the big league that we have the
big league. Big league. The first rule for the big league is you have to have won at least once. So that's what? That's me and you. Tom has won. So Sarah. The three of us are in. Sarah. So the four of us are in, and we can invite or pick two other players for the big league. And then we've got the and the rest.
The contender league.
The contender league, where we get all the people who...
So we're having them do it themselves? We're not even a part of it?
No. We're commissioners of that league. We officiate.
That does not sound like me drafting twice, which is really what I want to do.
That's the problem. Okay, see, you can't... That's not entertaining for the fans, though. You can't...
Well, wait a minute. Could AdBot be in the second league?
That's a if AdBot exists, and we don't know that he does.
I don't know. Maybe AdDragon could be in the second league. I don't know. I haven't heard from him in a while.
This is definitely the rule: is anytime you wear a mask, you get to be in a second league. Period. All of us can put on a mask and be in the other
league. Iris Sockman.
Yes.
Brian is only going to be in one league.
$30 pretending to not
El Kabong.
How do we take your bid if we pretend you're not there?
I kind of like this second other league, because then we can have a podcast, and we got a big pool of people who are playing.
Yeah. Now, is the second league have their own draft, or are they playing the way the chat realm plays?
No. Second league has their own draft.
Okay.
The future of this idea is in everybody who wants to having their own draft.
Yes.
In fact, I encourage chat realm and anybody watching, if you like this idea, between now and the next couple weeks, get some friends together and have your own league that you just tabulate rotisserie style or in a Google Doc.
What if... Okay, so the way the chat realm thing works right now is the way they do fantasy soccer in Europe, right? You get a set amount of money and you get to buy everything based on the rates that are set by the fantasy league.
Yeah.
What if... The top six league is the gold standard league that sets the price,
right?
But other leagues do it by rounds rather than auction.
Oh, like a snake draft?
So there's like the first pick goes to somebody, and then they have, you know, that comes out of their amount that they have, their 100.
We actually were on there's a Baltimore sports podcast.
I'll tell you what. Okay. Real quick, the more I think about it, this idea of a Kmart league, as insulting as it is to everybody who's in it, like the fact that there's four people who are made men who and women who get to be in like the real league, and then everyone else is competing to get in to this thing. I kind of love it. I kind of love it because it's two totally different stories. It's like you've got the people who are made, and that's the real game, and then you've got the everyone else. In a subcategory, top two get in each year.
And the bottom two get kicked out.
Yeah. Yeah. Top two in the Kmart League get in. Bottom two, like if you've gone, like maybe let's say you won a winter draft, well, then you're good through the summer. But if you're the...
I really don't know if I could handle getting kicked out of this league. Like, I really don't know psychologically.
It's, but you don't if I could get kicked withstand. Out, you just get bumped down to Division One.
Yeah, you just be in the other division.
The fact that I'm getting so emotional about it is the only reason why I think this is a good idea. Because it will be good drama.
I'm telling you, man.
I just had an emotional, visceral reaction to this.
I think the Premier League should set the price for the lower division.
No. They got to draft themselves.
No. Yeah,
because you have to show that you have that acumen.
Yeah, and
all right.
They also have the benefit of having watched the Premier League go first, right? And I'll tell you what, it also changes the game theory, because once you get into the Premier League, you're not playing to win. You're playing to not be in the bottom two.
Well, you're doing both. Yeah, exactly.
Well, no. Yeah, like, dude, once you're in the Premier League, all you want to do is stay in Premier League.
If you ain't first, you're last. I'm defending the only real title that matters, the Summer League title.
I love the way you're already discounting.
I'm going to start a January league. That's like all the crappy movies that come out between January and April. It's going to be the Arizona movie league.
Dude, I don't know about you guys. We could discuss this like off the air if you want, but I'm loving this idea. This is a good solution to the more people thing. I like the idea of having a second.
All right, so who's in the league that we're drafting tomorrow, and then who do we extend invitations to for
next week?
What I'm calling the Horse Apples conference.
Okay, until you're in it.
Until the lower division.
No. If I get relegated because all my movies suck, you have no idea how much more I will disparage it.
Okay, definitely in.
I'm furious about this idea. The only reason why, like, I'm even going along with it is because I understand that it is good radio.
Yes.
I hate this idea. I despise it. And I know it will bring me nothing but anger and consternation. It will keep me up at night. I am furious about it now, which is the only reason why it works.
I'm so glad to hear this. This is amazing. Okay. People who are definitely in the Premier League is all three of us, because we've all won at one point. Sarah Lane. Right. Has anyone else won?
By the way, current champion, reigning champion.
Who?
Me.
He's whatever. Just let him. Yeah.
I mean, of the summer.
Puerto Rican League winner. You want to bring out your sash and dance around?
Look. I already defeated the Summer League, and then I went on to conquer new territories. If you want to sit 8 years ago, league,
sure. You had your moment in the sun.
I can't wait till Jerry gets relegated from the Winter League just to double the pain. Not only did you get bumped down to the lower division, but it happened in the winter.
That's when I take my time to relax. The winter.
the winter. The
can't spell winter without winter.
The winter draft. WINNER.
You know, it's pretty close.
Okay, so how do we pick? How do we pick? I guess we should go by seniority.
By the way, now you've taken the question of who's in the top league to who do we pick now?
No,
we have to make hard decisions.
No, I don't. Whoever has participated the most has seniority. The most or the longest?
Well, the four of us who've won have participated the most.
Well, no. Yes. So we're already in. Well, plus we're winners. So
three of us and Sarah.
Yeah.
Right. Three of us and Sarah. So there's two more slots open.
As P. Del Hunty says, just check BBpedia. Oh, wait.
It's like, like Cargill's been in two.
Cargill's been in two.
Has Scott been in two? Veronica's been in one.
I think Cargill and F a Dog is what it's looking like.
Has Veronica only been in one or two?
She's only been in
Veronica's
one.
Veronica's been in two.
Only one. Only one. It was her first go round.
We had Glenn. We've had Padre SJ.
So yes. So that becomes the secondary league is a Padre SJ, Glenn, Veronica if she doesn't make the cut, Jason Murphy if he doesn't make the cut.
Well, I mean, listen, in the secondary league, I feel like that's our opportunity to invite new blood, though, right?
Yeah, no, that's true. So you're saying like,
I'm saying Spill. Who from Spill wants to come? Who from Film Riot wants to come? Who, by the way, participated previously? The Film Riot guys. Peter from Slash Film.
Kanata.
Yeah.
Kanata.
All of Canada.
Snubs.
Owen J.J. Stone.
A.K.A. O'Doctor.
Wait, did he play?
No, yeah. I'm talking about New Blood.
Oh, okay.
Because we don't allow those people in.
You know, winners.
People from New Jersey.
Can I just say how much respect I have for you, Justin, that like, the reason that you agree we should do this is because you hate it so much.
I mean, listen, man, I know which side my bread is buttered. Like, me freaking out and acting like a child and slamming my fist and screaming expletives is funny to people watching. And this is like a prime motivator for me to scream and yell and call you and Tom names for backing this. And
oh my God. I'm kind of down for this. I think this is great.
So are we, so next week it's it, right? It's on like Donkey Kong.
Yeah, we got it. We got to make our invites. We got to do everything. We got to figure out how we're going to,
so who's in? Three of us, Sarah, and then is it five or six?
As soon as BBpedia comes back, it should be six. Jason is definitely in. He's played once or twice, so he's in the Kmart League for sure.
Lower division.
I mean, because like we can fill the Kmart division with people who have also played, and we have no new blood.
Horse apples.
But this whole conversation was about new blood.
Well, you tell me. What do you want to do?
Owen is texting me now about protesting that there are no black players. And I would say,
wait a minute,
him,
two lower divisions.
I'll tell you what. He's a black player if I ever did see one.
All right. So what about, okay. So what if we start a movie draft podcast and then it's on the.
Bunbury says three divisions.
Well, no. And that's not even a terrible idea. Like an East and West lower division, and the top each goes to the Premier Division.
Premier Division, Division One, Division Two. There's relegation between those two.
No.
Yes.
You got Premier Division. You got
MLS Carnage. You should be ashamed of
you guys.
Oh, Jesus, this is getting fucking. Oh, damn it! Yeah. There's that. That's all we got. Damn it.
The belt.
Somebody just sent me a link to summer 2012 Hunger Games Wrath of the Titans. Ah, dude. This is a great game, and we need to grow it, and it's amazing.
I mean, honestly. Again, the future of this is the future of all fantasy leagues. The ability for everybody to get their group of friends together to play their own draft.
Yes.
That is the future.
That's actually what we need, is someone to code a site.
In fact, I'll tell you what. Here's a bounty. If you code a site that has draft functionality, you will be a one-third owner of that site with me and Brian.
Sure. Yes, agreed. So that anybody can play along and do this thing.
To our satisfaction, if we say this works to the functionality that we envision, you will be granted a third ownership of it wherever we go from here.
The chat room, they're saying, a wild T2T2 approaches. Oh my gosh.
What do you mean? Like, talking division. No. Why? Like
BCS.
Yeah, no, like every instance, like, so a friend, like me and my friends at home could
say.
Any
six people can make their own league and play their own rule and just follow along with us.
And so the only thing that we do at the site is set the movies.
Yeah.
And then eventually, as we go forward, you'll be able to customize the slate that you're picking from. But for right now, we just want someone to be able to draft their own movies. And then watch as they go along.
It's a great game.
A-Rod's starting the year on the DL, by the way.
I thought I moved him down. I moved him down? I guess I didn't save my roster then. I tried to move it down.
You have to hit the set lineup button. It's kind of annoying.
I know. Well, it's like that on ESPN for football, but I didn't know for baseball.
Dude.
You need a third baseman.
I can't start Hanley at third?
Not after today.
Oh, crap. Really?
Well, I don't know how serious it was, but he hurt himself in the WBC.
Oh, crap. He did?
Yeah.
Fart.
He may have just jammed his thumb, in which case you're probably fine. The hut is gorgeous.
Right? Oh, dude, you got like, you got skulls and crap over here to the side.
Wow.
That's
like,
that's
imagine this awesome. And that ambigram in the middle.
That kind of strikes the balance between what you and Justin were both saying and what you wanted out of it. Yeah. I feel like. And Justin, you want to Kickstarter a podcast where I lecture you about your baseball team? Matt 3 will fund us.
What the heck? Jeff says that the Beards were in Austin for South by Southwest, and I missed it. Son of a bitch.
Moo.
Remember when you were 14 and your dad taught you to shave? That wasn't a very fatherly way for him to behave. You had to watch your first beard floating down the drain. A beard abandoned, a son betrayed.
Well, maybe this is time to take it to Justin.
Let's take it. We're shutting it down. So long, I mean, Jammer B. It was a
thank
delight
you guys.
While we did.
Good night, sweet Jammer B.
Love you, Jams.
And may angels take you to...
May flights of angels
sing thee to thy rest.
Right. Also...
To thy streams.
Have a PBR.
But not a PBX machine in the basement.
No. Central.com.
No. Or an XNBC machine. Oh. Hi, Jammer B. Love you.
It's time to go and I'm so depressed and I'm gonna spend the rest of the week in bed until the next.
I was like, oh my God, like nice for all this
NSFW. The show is through and it breaks my heart cause I just can't bear to be apart from Brian and Justin of NSFW. Oh, I'd rather die in a fire then you spend a single moment without Brian Brushwood. Oh, I'd rather be dipped in honey and fed to a big ant pile than do without Justin Robert Young for even a little while. Oh, NSFW, I love you.
Space.com.
Oh, NSFW, I love you.
Welcome to Tech News Today. I'm Tom.